Okay, I'd like to call forward all the skulls that are in the opening.
Star, this is what I am. I am older now, more experienced. I have been a leader in my troop for at least 4 months. I have earned 6 merit badges. I have done 6 hours of service for my community. I actively participate in all the troop functions and encourage other scouts to do likewise. This is a 4 step of the ladder. I can almost be the top.
Like, I am now a scout for life. I have shown my willingness by showing leadership in my troop and earning a total of 11 merit badges. I have been a scout who actively does service for others and continues to guide and help my younger scouting brothers. I am only 1 step left. I have only 1 step left to reach my goal.
Eagle Scout. I am the Eagle Scout. This is the highest award the Scout may earn. To get to this point, I have earned 21 merit badges. I have been a scout who has been active and living by the scout oath and law for at least 20 months. I have planned and completed a service project which has helped my community in some way. And by demonstrating my leadership abilities in the troop, I have proven what I am capable of accomplishing. Yes, I am the Eagle. I have reached the top.
I'd like to thank you all for coming. If all the new scouts would just meet with Dave over there for just a moment. All the scouts who just came in last month. For those are new to a Boy Scout Court of Honor, there's a few things I'd like to point out to you before you start asking questions. You're going to notice a lot of left-handed handshakes today. The reason we shake with our left hand is because that's the Boy Scout handshake. So we're not doing things backward or anything like that. It's just the way Scouts do things. Also, when we hand out the ranks today, parents, wait till your scout comes toward you and escorts the mother up. The father just kind of follow along behind. Because when we hand out the ranks, there's going to be a little pin for the mother, and we're going to hand the ranks to the father first, who will then present them to the scout, who will then present his mother with the pin. That's kind of how we do things. Okay. In our scouting program, anytime a new scout comes in, there's a few requirements he has to do in order to become a Boy Scout or to be considered a Boy Scout. He has to understand the scout oath, law, motto, slogan, and outdoor code. He has to know the square knot. He has to go through a pamphlet about drug abuse, child abuse, and things like that with his parents. And I know there's a few questionable looks out there from some of the parents of older scouts. They didn't have to do this up until last year. It's what part of the new program that scouting has. Tonight we have several new scouts we'd like to induct into the troop, or new boys, I should say, who wish to become scouts. The senior patrol leader, you want to come forward? Senior patrol leader, who are these with you?
These are our candidates. They wish to join our troop and become a scout. They've met all the requirements and are duly qualified.
Good. In doing so, remember now that you're vouching for these scouts. Scouts, unclasp your hands. You have been admitted to our troop to be made a member of the greatest boys movement in the world. Place your... No, I can't do that part. Raise your hand on the scout sign. Now, I need badges for these scouts. Hopefully, we have some here tonight. Do we have a scout who has a badge for Mike Kradinsky?
Sir, I'll offer you a scout badge to
him. Would you come forward, please, and present him with the badge? Do we have a badge for Josh Kohanek?
Sir, I offer my scout badge to
him. Would you please come forward and present him with his badge? Does anyone have a badge for Corey Spoden? Would you please come forward and present it to me? Do we have a badge for Eric Sunder?
Sure. I'll have my badge for Eric.
Would you please come forward and present him with your badge? Do we have a badge for Nathan Christensen?
Sir, I offer my badge to this candidate.
Would you please come forward and present him with that badge? Does anyone have a badge for Tom Hansen?
Sir, I offer my badge to this candidate.
Would you please come forward and present it to him? And do we have a badge for Shane Dufault? Would you please come forward and present it to him? Candidates, to become a Boy Scout, I would now like you to recite the scout oath. Hands raised. On my honor, I will do my best to do my duty to God and my country, to obey the scout law, to help other people at all times, to keep myself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight. Two.
Candidates, you have been given a badge that has been worn with honor and distinction by a scout who has gone before you. This shows our friendship for you and the trust we place in you. By the authority vested in me by the National Council, Boy Scouts of America, I declare you Boy Scouts. Court, I'd like to present to you the newest members of Troop 68.
And you may be seated. You may be seated. Okay, we've just seen a whole batch of new kids come into scouting. But of course, we don't want to forget the boys who stayed with scouting for a while. So tonight, we have some year pins. We have some year pins we'd like to present to those scouts who are celebrating an anniversary in Boy Scouting this year. Or at this time, I should say. Would the following scouts please come forward? Jason Fuchs, Jason Christensen, Tom Schleicher, William Majerus, and Ben Sieben. And Billy Hinnekamp.
Billy, did he come in with you?
Okay, these scouts have been in for 1 year. It was 1 year ago they were Weeblow scouts that went through a ceremony very similar to the one we just had. Jason, there you are. Congratulations. Would Nathan Blummel, Jason Pradinsky, and Tim Dingman please come forward? These scouts are celebrating their second anniversary as a Boy Scout. Would Matt Mose, Greg Monroe, Scott Hollerman, Tim Nathy, and Jason Pradinsky please come forward? Whoops. Jason Tarraway, excuse me. You could say these scouts are middle-aged scouts, because they've been in the troop for 3 years. We're getting to the senior citizens in the troop now. Would Tony Beard, Josh Bowden, and Ross Ferricks come forward? They're not quite senior citizens, but they have celebrated 4 years as a Boy Scout. It's not very often I get to hand out one of the next pins here. It's a 5-year pin. This scout has spent about 1/3 of his life as a Boy Scout, probably longer than that if you count Cub Scouting. Would John Rosner please come forward? Congratulations. I would now like to call forward our senior patrol leader, Dave Strong, to hand out the merit badges.
First of all, would Matt Most please come forward? He has earned aviation merit badge. Would Tim Nathy, John Rosner, and Jason Kramer please come forward? They have all earned a Space Exploration Merit Badge. John Mossman, please come forward. He's not here. Okay, he earned Camping Merit Badge. Okay, the next group of scouts here, they've each earned two merit badges each. Would Tony Beard come forward? Tony has earned Pottery and Cinematography. Nathan Blimmel. Nathan has earned Space Exploration and Camping. Tim Dingman. Tim has earned Space Exploration and Camping. To call forward Steve to hand out the last merit badges.
Okay, you've seen that some of the scouts were real busy earning one or two merit badges, but we've got two scouts who are super busy and earned three each. Would Ross Frericks come forward? Ross has been busy the past couple of months drafting a new computer for the NASA space shuttle. By doing this, he earned the Drafting Merit Badge, the Computer Merit Badge, and the Space Exploration Merit Badge.
Good job, Ross.
While Ross was working on drafting the equipment, Dave was busy filming this computer for the NASA space program. Would Dave, you want to come forward? Dave has earned Cinematography, Computers, and Space Exploration. Good job. I would now like Jason Christensen and Tom Schleicher and their parents to please come forward. In the days of the Red Man, when the Indian boy prepared for manhood, he was required to go through a stern ordeal, testing his worthiness and fitness for a place among the braves of his tribe. If he passed through this ordeal successfully, he appeared before the council fire to receive the eagle feather of the brave. As the chief placed in his hands the weapons of his rank, he pledged the new brave to an oath. He bound him in honor never to use his weapons in any way that would bring discredit to him or his tribe. The days of the red man are gone, but their spirit lives on in the hearts of all true scouts. Just as the Indian youth went through his ordeal to prove himself, so you scouts have gone through your second class rank requirements to prove yourself a scout hiker who can care for himself in the outdoors. Just as the Indian youth pledged himself to his tribe, so should you pledge yourself to scouting and maintain the scout oath and the scout law. In your growth toward becoming a scout hiker, do you scouts feel that the scout oath and the law have become more meaningful to you personally? This rank of second class scout hiker represents to you the opportunities for service to others, as did the weapons to the Indian youth. We place no weapons in your hands, but the honor of all scouting as surely rests on your shoulders. Scouts, once before you stood before this court and became Tenderfoot Scouts. Time has passed since then. You have used that time well in pursuing your scout activities and knowledge. You are now qualified to assume the title and duties of second-class scout. I know that you will wear the second-class badge as a shield with honor and distinction. To prove that you know the rules by which this award may be borne honorably, you will repeat the scout law. Signs up. A scout is?
Trustworthy, loyal, helpful, friendly, kind, obedient, courteous, cheerful, courageous, courageous, and loyal.
Okay. Honorable Court, I present to you the newest second-class scouts of Melrose Troop 68. Would Philip Johannek and his parents please come forward? Now let's go back to the days of chivalry. After a squire had earned the right to carry sword and shield, it was customary to retire to the privacy of the chapel on the evening before he was to be made a knight. There, surrounded by his weapons, he prayed that he might live worthy of the honor that was his, that he might never bring disgrace on his knighthood, either in thought or in deed. Just as highly as the knights of old, we who are scouts of today value the distinction that is ours. As a first-class scout, Phil, you have earned the right to demonstrate and abide by the code to which a true and mature scout is forever bound by a scout oath and law. Do you accept the greater responsibility of first-class scout in the spirit of the service of the knights of old?
I do.
In qualifying for first-class rank, you have advanced from scout hiker to more skillful living in the outdoors for longer periods of time. This experience, you have become a scout camper, better able to take care of yourself and others, as did the knights of old. As we present you with your first-class badge, I charge you to continue in your development as a scout so that you may better serve your fellow men in the spirit of chivalry. Philip, I would also like to present you with this certificate proclaiming that you're halfway to your eagle. What? You gotta shake hands. Members of the court, I'd now like to present Philip Johannek, our newest first-class scout. I have one more rank to award tonight. Would Tim Dingwin and his Clarence please come forward? Quiet. Parents. Happy? History will record two types of deeds. The deeds of the great scouts of the past, through whom we have received America, and the deeds of scouts today, which will determine the type of heritage which we leave to the future. The bold, rugged characters of George Washington, Daniel Boone, George Rogers Clark, and a host of others were gained in the stern, robust life of the primitive outdoors. We cannot today perform the deeds of old scouts, but we can live the outdoor life they lived, and we can model our lives along the solid lines laid down by them. In this way, the heritage we leave to those who follow will be a worthy reflection of the heritage we receive from those great scouts of the past. In light of this heritage, do you, Tim, as life scout, renew the pledge of service to your fellow men that made you a star scout?
Yeah. Yes.
This court of honor finds you fully qualified for the rank of life scout. The rank of eagle awaits you as you continue on the trail to scouting. As I present you with this rank of life scout, may the red heart of the badge be a constant reminder of the fine things you have received from scouting and of the fine things that you carry in your heart as a pledge to scouting and your fellow man. Tim, the heart has always been an emblem of courage, strength, and service to others. Indeed, it is the emblem of life itself. You are now entering the final step and rocky trail that leads to the summit, the rank of Eagle Scout. This Life Scout heart symbolizes the strength and courage that you will need to scale the final heights, at last to join the great brotherhood of Eagle Scouts. It also reminds you to keep yourself physically strong, mentally awake, and morally straight, and to be of service to others. Honorable Court, I would now like to present to you the newest first Life Scout of Melrose Troop 68. Uses to symbolize at each court of honor the scout who has done the most advancing since we last met at a court of honor. How we do this is we rate them as per the awards they get. For each merit badge a scout earns, he gets 50 points. For each rank he earns, he gets 150, and for the eagle rank, he gets 200. Tonight we have a scout who has earned two merit badges, right? And the rank of life scout. Would Tim Dingwin please come forward? Congratulations, Tim. I would now like to call forward our advancement chairman, Mr. Vern Dingwin, to hand out the troop bucks.
Okay, for some of you people that don't know what troop bucks are, all they are is Monopoly money. And they get $20 for each outing, $50 for each merit badge, $150 for each rank, and $200 for Eagle. We only gave out two Eagle ones. Greg Monroe. It's $20 for one outing. Nathan Christensen. It's $20 for one outing. Shane DeFoe. It's $20 for one outing. Tom Hansen, it's $20 for one outing. Josh Jahanek, it's $20 for one outing. Corey Sproden, it's $20 for one outing. Eric Sunder, it's $20 for one outing. Jamie Mouse, he gets $40 for two outings. Peter Orth, Peter gets $40 for two outings. Josh Bowden, he gets $40 for two outings. Jason Kramer, Jason gets $50 for one merit badge. Billy Hennekamp, Billy gets $60 for three outings. Scott Hollerman, Scott gets $60 for three outings. Paul Strong gets $60 for three outings. Tim Nathy, Tim gets $90 for two outings and one marathon. John Rosner, gets $90 for one merit badge and two outings. Matt Mose, Matt gets $110. He's got three outings and one merit badge. Nathan Blummel, Nathan gets $140. He's got two merit badges and two outings. Tony Beard gets $160 for two merit badges and three outings. Jason Christensen gets $170. He's got one rank and one outing. Ross Ferrix gets $170. He's got three merit badges and one outing. Philip Jahanek, it's $190. He's got one rank and two outings. Yes. Tom Schleicher gets $210. He's got one rank and three outings. Dave Strong gets $210. He's got three merit badges and three outings. And Tim Dingman. Tim gets $310. He's got two merit badges, one outing, and three outings, and one rank. That should do it, Steve.
Okay, I'd like to call forward our committee chairman, Mike Rosner, to help me with the next presentations. Okay. Once a year, our troop gathers at a court of honor, and not only do we recognize scouts for the achievements that they've earned, but we like to recognize either people in our community or organizations in our community who have helped the scouting program in some way. Tonight we have two organizations that we would like to honor. About 3 years ago? Is it three, Cal? Four? About 4 years ago, Melrose kind of formed their own television station that goes out over cable TV here in town. Shortly after that formation, Troop 68 started broadcasting their Court of Honors. Not only the Court of Honors, but we've kind of expanded to include some of our campouts and summer camps and various other things. Also during that time, a few of our scouts have become quite involved with Mel-TV in the process. The reason we're honoring Mel-TV tonight is because of the promotion that scouting has received through them. By letting us have our Court of Honors and things on the TV channel, the community now is more aware of scouting in town, and people in town accept scouting a lot more than they used to. Also, it seems that boys as a whole now accept scouting a lot more than what was used to, or what how it used to be accepted. Because I can remember back in the early 80s, the Boy Scouts back then didn't even want it known that they were Boy Scouts. They wanted it kept a secret. Well, nowadays it seems the Scouts don't mind anymore, at least here in town. Although I hear that in other cities in the area, kids still don't want it known that they're Boy Scouts. But thanks to Mel-TV and others, Boy Scouting is accepted and in fact encouraged now in town. So I'd like to ask Cal and Bill Meyer, who are representing Mel-TV tonight, to come forward to accept the award from our chairman.
The plaque says, "In grateful recognition of services rendered to scouting." So, in appreciation, small token.
Thank you very much. We're very pleased, and we have to thank the scouts also for all their help. Steve is on our board of directors. I see Mary Monroe back there. She's one of our great volunteers. And the scouts have done many, many things for us. I think they're wonderful. Thank you all very much.
Okay, the next organization that we'd like to sponsor has been with the troop for 10 years. Back in December of 1979, when the current troop began, a sponsor was needed because the scout troop cannot function without some organization in town sponsoring it. So the call went out and the VFW post number 7050 came forward and volunteered to be the sponsor of the troop, and they've been with us ever since. During those years, the VFW has provided us with quite a bit of assistance, mainly in providing us a meeting place in the wintertime known as St. Mary's Gym. They've taken care of the cost for that. Also, just lately, they've given us the money to buy ourselves, or for our troop, to purchase another Eureka tent, which we are in desperate need of with 36 scouts now. We've had some rocky times over the years, but I think a lot of that was due to the misinformation, or just that each other didn't know what each other was supposed to do. I remember when we first started, we kind of left each other alone off to our own things, but things have gone a lot smoother now that we've been cooperating with each other and working with each other. We not only have an award to hand them today, but we also have their 11th charter to present to the VFW. So would Ray Zenzen please come forward?
Well, Ray, as you know, that without the VFW, scouts couldn't exist. We need a charging organization. And as Steve said, through the years, we certainly have donated a lot of money to our organization. And they've certainly been a real believer in scouting. And it's been very beneficial not only to have Ray Zenzen being the commander this year, but he's also the liaison between the scouting and the VFW organization. So as long as you stay commander, forever and ever, we got this in the bag.
My term is just about up. We got a new commander coming up.
Oh,
for a year, anyhow.
We'll get you back in the year after.
I'm back to senior vice commander, that isn't now.
Well, Ray has gone back with many requests to the VFW from our committee meetings, and with a lot of success, I might add. So we certainly appreciate that. And I didn't know about another tent since the last committee meeting. Thank you.
Okay,
okay, again, the same plaque we're giving to the VFW in grateful recognition of services rendered to scouting. And then, okay, and then the other one is where would they hang it here, the VFW, it just says that they're the chartering organization for the Boy Scouts. Okay.
Thank you very much.
I would now like to ask our senior patrol leader and his assistant to please come forward. And would you two please retire the colors? Scouts, stand. Scout salute. And retire the colors.